Lord Jesus, I thank you, God, for my wife, Father. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for the spirit of a teacher you gave her, God, as a little girl.
Yes.
Lord Jesus, I thank you for the gifting you've given her, God. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that as her husband, God, that she has built me up with her gifts and talents, God, with the anointing that's on her life. Lord, I pray for everybody here tonight, God. Lord Jesus, they would hear a word from you, God.
Yeah.
They would hear your voice, Jesus, as I hear your voice through her,
yes.
God. They would hear your voice through her as well. Lord Jesus, I pray right now for the translator, God. I pray for that. Lord, I pray for the power of God, Lord Jesus, the rest of the
Christians.
I pray for the fire of God to be in this place, God. We need to hear your voice, Jesus. We give you great praise in the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus' name.
Amen. First, I want to thank Pastor Steve for giving me the opportunity. I was a little shocked.
Gracias, Pastor Staten, por el elegirme.
And I do not take it lightly.
No lo tomo muy leve.
The task that he set before me today.
Lo que me ha proporcionado hacer hoy.
I thank my husband.
Le doy gracias a mi esposo.
Because at the last minute, he took the kids so that I could prepare.
Usted tomó cargo de los niños para que yo pueda preparar.
I got to come home and the house was clean and the kids were
yes,
asleep.
Llegué a casa y...
But I also got to realize what exactly it is he does when he goes to prepare.
Pero tuve la oportunidad de sentir lo que él necesita hacer para preparar.
And a little bit of the fear of God that he feels when he steps behind his pulpit.
Y el temor de Dios cuando él viene acá a predicar.
So I thank you.
Amen.
First, I'd like to ask you to stand to read the word with me today. We're going to go to James chapter 1.
Por favor, paren para que podamos leer James chapter 1.
And we're going to use the English Standard Version. It's not very different from the King James. But it says, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds.
Hermanos míos, tened por sumo gozo cuando veis en deberías tentación. Santiago 1:2.
For you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness.
Sabiendo que la poder de vosotros fe obra presencia.
And let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing.
Mas tenga la presencia perfecta su obra para que seas perfectos y trabajes sin falta en alguna cosa.
And you may be seated. Webster, the dictionary.
Diccionario Webster.
Defines the word trial.
Define la palabra trial.
As a test of faith.
Como una prueba de fe.
Patience.
Paciencia.
Or stamina.
Stamina.
Through subjection,
por,
or through going through,
o por pasar algo,
suffering,
sufrimiento,
or temptation.
O tentación.
We can all think
nosotros podemos pensar
of people in the Bible
de las gentes en la escritura
who experienced trials.
Que han vivido por pruebas.
And so in the elementary school world,
en la secundaria,
we say something like turn and talk.
Se dice, tiene un dicho como voltear y hablar.
Just want you to take 2 seconds, turn to your neighbor and see if you can name someone from the Bible who went through a trial.
So ahora le pido que hablen con sus vecinos y hablen de alguna persona que también
ha pasado. David, hallelujah, yes. Abraham.
But let's see if my list matches yours.
Pero vamos a decir mi lista de
How about Adam and Eve?
God left them now.
They came up with a great trial of whether to or not to eat the fruit.
Yes.
Especially Adam, because he had to choose, do I listen to my wife or to God?
Did
anybody mention Abraham and Sarah?
Yeah.
First, they're faced with the trial of waiting. Then they're faced with the trial of having a child at an old age. And then they're faced with having to sacrifice that very promise from God. How about Moses? I'm sorry, I think I went out of order. I got lost in my notes. First Noah, you're right.
Primero Noé.
He had to face the crowd and tell them he was building an ark.
Tenía que hablar con la gente y decirle que tengo que construir un arca.
When it had never rained.
Yeah. Y cuando llueva.
Okay, now Moses.
Ahora Moisés.
First he had to face Pharaoh, not once.
Ahora tenía que
not just one time.
Tenía que hablar con Faraón no nomás una vez,
but like 11 times.
Pero como 11 veces.
Okay, and then once they did leave, he had to face the children of Israel.
Ya después de que se fueron, tenía que estar con los hijos de Israel.
This picture behind me, I love, is Joseph.
Jonathan leaves worship and pray.
First, he's sold into slavery by his own brothers.
Look like Jonathan leaves worship and praise.
And then he had to run from Potiphar's wife. How about Job?
Jacob.
He lost everything. Has anyone ever had one boy oil? He had the sickness from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet.
La enfermedad era desde arriba hasta abajo de su cuerpo.
How about Hannah? How about Peter? I'm sure that whole scene where he was denying Jesus three times wasn't easy. I'm sure it was a trial.
Y Pedro negó a Jesús tres veces.
About Paul and Silas.
Paul and Silas.
Locked in a jail. I'm sure right now you think that the $1 million question is why?
¿Por qué? ¿Quieren saber por qué?
Why do people who are called and chosen by God go through these trials?
Están pasando por tribulación.
James told us that you might be perfect and complete. Lacking in nothing. So the truth is that trials are supposed to add something to our lives.
Hallelujah.
No one can escape trials. They're going to come. And most of the time, you're not going to expect it. And whether you like it or not, you're
going to
have more than one. So the true
question
is how do we go through these trials? The topic that Pastor gave you was grace for the trial. I looked at 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 1 through 16. We're not going to display them all. I'm just going to give you a short synopsis of what goes on in this chapter. This passage in 1 Peter,
en el primer capítulo de Pedro,
Peter is writing to a select group of people.
Él está yendo a unas personas seleccionadas.
These men were chosen of God.
Estos hombres fueron elegidos de Dios.
They have been born again.
Ellos fueron nacidos otra vez.
They believed on God.
Creyeron en Dios.
They had the blood of Jesus applied to their lives.
Tenían la sangre de Jesús también.
Some commentators say that it was on the day of Pentecost.
Unos dicen que era el día de Pentecostés.
Others say that Peter had won them to the Lord.
Y otros dicen que unos los ganaron a Dios.
But what we see in verse 2 of that chapter
en versículo 2,
is that these men had been dispersed into five different areas that were not their homes.
Ellos fueron
in five different areas. They were moved.
Fueron movidos a diferentes áreas.
That were not their home.
Que no eran su casa.
They were strangers.
Eran extraños.
And they were going through a trial of their faith.
Y estaban pasando una prueba de su fe.
Sounds a lot like us, right?
Mm-hmm.
This world is not my home.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just passing through.
Mm-hmm.
And we go through trials. In verse 13, we see Peter begin to exhort them that there were several things they needed to do during the trial of their faith.
En versículo 13, Pedro dice qué tenemos que hacer para sobrepasar las pruebas.
I'm going to let her display it, but I'm just going to summarize it. The first thing he tells them to do is prepare your minds for action.
El primer paso es que preparemos nuestras mentes.
This isn't the time to say, oh, poor me.
Este no es el tiempo de
I quit.
Right.
I'm just going to lay in my bed. I'm moving. This is the time that this is the time where you prepare your mind for action. Does this sound familiar?
Hallelujah.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Amen.
Which begins with the helmet of salvation.
Yes.
How about this one? Think on things that are lovely.
Mm.
Think on things that are true.
Yes.
Think on things that are honest.
Mm.
Don't think about the lies the devil is telling you.
Yeah. Wow.
Hallelujah.
Think about the things that are pure.
Hallelujah.
Think about things that have a good report.
Yes.
Think about things that are excellent.
Las cosas excelentes también.
Think about things that are praiseworthy.
También para alabar.
When you're in the trial,
cuando estás en la prueba,
memorize the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Recall those things you learned in your past.
Recuérdese de las cosas del pasado.
The second thing Peter tells them to do is to be sober.
Y también la segunda cosa es que estén
we'll define it, how's that? That word that he tells them to do is to be modest.
Que sea modesto.
To be moderate.
Que también sea moderno.
To be stable minded.
Que sea establemente.
You know, throughout the Bible, old men are told to be sober, to be stable minded.
Las gentes más viejitas tienen que estar con mente estable.
Young men are told to be sober.
También tienen que ser.
And ladies, you don't get off. Ladies are told to be sober.
Las mujeres también son
in the way we dress.
En las formas que nos vestimos.
In the way we speak.
En la forma que
hablamos. That's everybody. That's not just women. Everybody.
Yes.
And what we listen to.
Help us, Lord.
Be sober. The next thing he says, and this is where I want to focus a little bit, set your hope fully.
Y la final paso sería estableces tu fe.
Fully on the grace that you receive
completamente en la gracia de él.
When Jesus is revealed.
Cuando Jesucristo se ha revelado.
Hold on, let's break it down a little bit. How many of you ever felt hopeless?
Man.
When you're in the trial of your faith,
man.
Come on, raise your hand.
Man.
You feel hopeless. Yes. You don't know how to fix it.
Yes.
So he exhorts them, set your hope on grace.
Establece
su fe en la
gracia.
You can't fix it.
Amen. Amen. Well,
what is grace?
Pero ¿qué es gracia?
Grace means unmerited, which just means I didn't earn it.
No. Gracia simplemente significa que yo no me lo merecí.
I didn't work for it.
Yo no trabajé por él.
I didn't earn it.
Yo tampoco no me lo
merecí. I didn't deserve it.
No me lo merezco.
Favor. So grace is unmerited favor.
Es como lo positivo de favor.
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 Is much like, you know, that favorite pair of shoes you wear.
Como tus zapatos favoritos que tengas.
You use them all the time.
Que los usas todo el tiempo.
Cologne. It's like the object that you like the most.
You like the one I got on the day.
Another way to describe it is blessings.
Como bendiciones.
They always
unmerited favor.
I don't know, once
or the blessings of God.
Their whole life.
Bendiciones de Dios.
So Peter tells them.
This one is called Must Imperial.
Got
it from New York. Very good.
As God has
revealed.
Designer.
I'll come back to that. And it says, be obedient to God.
Company called Atelier.
Obedezca a Dios.
It says, don't go back to the things that you were doing in your ignorance.
No regreses a las cosas que hacías.
In other words, it says, don't backslide.
Yes.
Don't give up on God.
No te venzas por Dios.
And then he says, be holy. As he is holy.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Don't backslide.
Hallelujah.
Be pure.
Yes.
In all of your conduct.
Yes.
And then the last thing he tells them in summary, call on him.
Llama él.
Yes.
When you don't know what else to do, call on him.
Hallelujah.
When you're heavy, you're in the middle of a trial, call on him.
Llama él.
Yes.
As you might have figured out by now, trials of faith did not stop with John on the Isle of Patmos.
Las pruebas no pararon durante ese tiempo.
As he wrote the book of Revelation.
Mientras que estaba escribiendo el libro del Apocalipsis.
We still experience them today.
Todavía los experimentamos.
And there's one little reason that we can count it all joy.
Y hay una razón para que podamos gozarnos.
And it's because as you go through this trial of your faith,
porque durante las pruebas,
more of God is going to be revealed to you.
Más de Dios se va a revelar.
You will have
a yes.
You will have a blessing.
Hallelujah.
Because the blessings and unmerited favor comes as He's revealed.
Yes.
Y las bendiciones llegan mientras que Él viene.
We can count it all joy because it means God is still calling me.
He's
still choosing me. He's still preparing me for His purpose. And He's going to show me more of Him. I'm not standing here as someone who's just read about it in the Bible.
No estoy aquí nomás para decirle que yo lo he leído en la escritura.
I too have experienced trials of my faith.
Yo también tengo las experiencias.
Being a mom of three small boys presents them on a daily basis.
That's three trials every day.
However, many of you know my story or my testimony. But I've rarely ever shared it at this moment. I've always asked God to use my story to help someone else. And today I'm going to give a brief summary. Not of the only trial of my faith.
Que no era la única prueba de mi fe.
But one of the biggest trials of my
faith. Era una de las grandes.
But I really want to focus.
Pero también me quiero enfocar.
On what God's unmerited favor.
Pero también lo que Dios me ha dado favorismo.
Gave to me as a result of the trial.
Por los resultados de la prueba.
On August 26, 2006.
En agosto de 2006.
I married a drug addict.
Yo me casé con un drogadicto.
I can take time trying to explain how.
Yo me puedo tomar mi tiempo y explicarles cómo.
Or why.
O por qué.
But that really won't change the story at this point.
Pero eso no va a cambiar la historia.
1 month into that marriage, I found a crack bag under the clutch pedal of my car. I'm going to stop you just for 1 second.
Yes, sir, Jesus.
When I was preparing for this last night, I haven't felt the hurt of this story in 8 years. Every time I tell it, it feels like I'm telling someone else's story. But last night, God let me feel it again. And I sat on my couch and felt it being pulled out like I haven't felt it in a long time. So I know God wants to minister today.
Yes.
After I found that clutch pedal, it was 2 weeks later that at that time my new husband moved to Illinois to be part of a rehabilitation program.
Two weeks.
And I'm sparing you a lot of the details, okay? 10 months later, this was just 17 days before our first anniversary.
17 días antes de nuestro aniversario.
Primero. I moved to Illinois.
Yo me moví a Illinois.
I left my family.
Dejé mi familia.
I left my church.
Dejé mi iglesia.
I left everything I knew.
Dejé todo de lo que yo sabía.
To be there.
Para estar ahí.
He graduated out of the program at the beginning of October.
Se graduó de un programa en
pero octubre. His very first night of freedom.
En su primer noche de libertad.
He was involved in a car accident that should have decapitated him.
Fue le pasó un accidente donde se cortó, fue decapitado.
Because he wanted to help Duster.
Porque quería ayudar.
If you don't know what that is, it's not even a real drug. By Thanksgiving, he was back to using pot.
Otra vez había regresado a droga.
Marijuana. And my undesired career
y mi carrera que no fue deseo,
as an in-home detective began.
Y como detective empezó.
For 7 months, I experienced verbal, emotional, and even religious abuse.
Durante ese tiempo, yo sentí abuso de físico, mental, y religiosamente.
In which he would taunt me and ridicule me.
Durante ese tiempo que también me decía malas cosas.
For clinging to my God.
Por estar clamándole a Dios.
I constantly felt like I was on the verge of a nervous breakdown.
Siempre me sentía como que me iba a tener un nervio que me iba a sacar.
And like I was going psychotic.
Que me estaba volviendo loco.
Finally in May.
En mayo.
I sat across the table with my principal.
Y me senté con mi principal.
Who looked at me and said, "You're not even half the teacher you were when you moved here." And that was a calling I'd had since I was 5 years old. And I knew something had to change. My mom flew out to be with me.
Mi mamá fue para estar conmigo.
And it truly was in a series of miraculous events that God freed me from that marriage.
Pasó muchas maravillas que Dios me liberó de ese matrimonio.
Because I believed the word of God, but I didn't have a reason to divorce until the unbeliever put me away.
Que no tenía ningún motivo de divorciarme hasta que El hombre fue sanado.
That May, he asked me for a divorce.
Durante mayo, me pidió divorcio.
While I was instantly freed from the immediate abuse,
fui liberada de ese abuso.
I moved back home as a very damaged,
regresé a casa bien quebrada.
And hurting young woman.
Y diferente.
With no hope.
Sin fe.
Or what I thought was no hope.
O lo que yo pensé que no era fe.
That God's dreams for my life could ever be fulfilled.
Que mis sueños que tenía de que eran por Dios.
I know I'm usually an open book, and that what you see is what you get.
Normalmente soy como un libro abierto, lo que mira soy.
But at that point in my life,
fue ese punto de mi vida.
The wounds were so deep.
It was kind of like
one of the worst burns you can have, where your nerve endings get damaged. And you can't really feel the pain. I went into such a deep place of numbness. I was so numb. I can't even remember certain things for the next year.
Estaba tan quebrada que no me recuerdo casi nada de ese año.
I didn't necessarily know how to pray.
No
deep prayers of intercession. But little by little, God began to heal the wounds one layer at a time.
Pero Dios empezó a ayudarme una capa por una capa.
And now I can look back.
Ahora puedo mirar atrás.
And I can tell you the things that God gave me.
Hallelujah.
Through his unmerited favor.
Hallelujah.
As a result of that horrible
yes.
time. The first thing he gave me, Brother Sky,
yes.
was my praise.
Hallelujah.
He gave me a song. How about something like this? Lead me, Lord.
Yes.
And I will follow.
Yes.
Oh.
Or how about keep pressing on, keep pressing on.
Hallelujah.
Until your broken heart has mended.
Hallelujah.
Sister, keep pressing on, keep pressing on.
Hallelujah.
Until you're what God has intended. How about this one? I have come to bow.
Yes.
My praise of him.
Hallelujah.
Like oil from Mary's alabaster box.
Hallelujah. Jesus.
How about the one, let your word speak to me and show me what I've never seen before. See, truly what it was, all the songs I sang as a child, as a teenager, became my prayers. And what God gave me when I took my praise into the trial of my faith, he birthed a worshiper. Somebody that gives him total and complete adoration.
Yes.
With nothing holding back.
Yes.
When you take your praise into your trial of your faith, it becomes a balm to your wounded spirit. And you will come out of worship. And you'll never go back. The second thing, again for the sky, as I took my praise into that, I found his presence. His presence.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah.
You know the old song that says he's as close as the mention of his name.
Hallelujah.
I can remember nights laying in the bed feeling so alone. And one night I laid there and cried. And I just said, Jesus, will you come and wrap your arms around me?
Hallelujah.
And he did.
Thank you.
I felt so much peace.
Yes.
Because that's the other thing he'll bring is his peace. When his presence is there, his peace is there.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Because the love
of your soul is right there with you.
Yes,
Lord. Oh, yeah, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. At the time, I would ask them questions, and a lot of time they were angry questions.
Y tenía muchas preguntas, y hay veces que eran preguntas cuando estaba bien enojada.
But he was so close that his voice was literally almost audible, like I'm talking to you.
Yes.
Estaba tan cerca que yo no podía escuchar su voz.
One of those times I was sitting in a stoplight getting ready to, I could take you right where it was in Huntington Park. I was going to Taco Bell. I know. I was going to Taco Bell. I told you were my sister from that lifetime. I was going to the Taco Bell. And I was sitting in the stoplight. I was so angry, and I took my fist and I hit the steering wheel of my car, and I said, "Whoa!"
Le pegué al volante del carro mientras que iba a un Taco Bell y pregunté por qué.
And even though I questioned his sovereignty as my God,
y hay veces que me quedaba preguntando que por qué.
He whispered back and took me by complete surprise.
Y él me respondía por una sorpresa completa.
He said, "Joey, will you forgive me?"
Y me pidió perdón.
And I continued to have a conversation with your God. You're perfect. How do I forgive you? And he said, right back to me. I mean, it was like a conversation. We're sitting right there in the car.
Estábamos teniendo una conversación frente a frente.
Because I didn't meet your expectations. I didn't meet your expectations.
Porque yo no llegué a tus expectativas.
And you're hurting.
Y estás dolida.
And forgiveness isn't about me.
Y el perdón no es de mí.
It's about
no se trata
you.
De mí.
Hallelujah.
It's about you,
Jimmy.
Se trata de ti.
There were other instances like that. One thing that I can tell you from that experience is that the trial of your faith,
la prueba de tu fe,
will teach you to recognize the voice of God.
Hallelujah. Yes, it will. Yes, it will.
It will teach you to feel.
Yes. Yes.
There are times when I walk into a room.
Hallelujah.
I don't have to, and please let me preface it. I don't mean you don't need to pray. You need to pray.
Right.
You need to have communion with God. But there are going to be times when I'm with my kids and I'm not necessarily getting down on my knees and interceding before the Lord.
Hay tiempos que llego y no estoy intercediendo en frente de Dios.
But I'll walk into a room.
Y estoy en frente de un cuarto.
And I'll feel it.
Yes.
Because the trial of your faith will teach you to recognize when he's there.
Yes.
Por las pruebas de tu fe.
It will also teach you that it's okay.
También te va a enseñar que está bien.
And it's even good.
Y es bueno.
To have deep.
De tener profundo.
Meaningful. And sometimes painful.
Y también con dolor.
Heart-to-heart talks with God.
Conversaciones de corazón a corazón.
I'm going to just kind of go through the next two. The next thing I learned to recognize was his provision.
Y también sus provisiones.
In little ways. I'm going to move on because I'm running out of time. Mm-hmm. The next thing that God gave me were his people.
Y también estoy...
Hallelujah.
They were so instrumental in helping me heal. Eric was a direct answer to my prayer.
Hallelujah.
For hope that the hurt would go away.
Yes.
What I later found out was a few months after meeting me. Or maybe weeks, I don't know, it was a
whirlwind.
He began to pray
él empezó a orar.
That God would use him to take the hurt out of my eyes. My parents, my siblings, this church that we hope you see, and my church in Lexington Park, Pastor and Sister Lumpkin, and even my ex's parents would continually take me to the throne room when I couldn't get there myself.
Hallelujah.
I learned through the trial of my faith how important it is to be connected to the body of believers.
Yes.
We carry each other. We bear one another's burdens. And we truly exercise the motto of no man left behind. The last thing that his blessing, that he blessed me with. He used the word power just to keep up the alliteration. But I guess I would have to say his anointing.
Man.
Since God's restored me, I have had several opportunities to minister to other ladies in six similar situations. And there's always a special anointing to minister to their unique needs with compassion and understanding that I would have never had if I hadn't gone through the trial. I'm not telling you your trial is the same as mine. But his blessings are not just for me.
Hallelujah.
He's not a respecter of persons.
All right.
If you'll do the things that you're exhorted to do, his grace will carry you through.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Wow. We had powerful lessons already today. I'm anxious to get into some prophecy here. I want to praise you.
Hallelujah.
I think